My favorite thing by far is catching butterflies. I don't know, it's just really relaxing. I just kind of like feel like I'm, actually outside searching for butterflies. So this is my Python notebook that I worked on last week to analyze Animal Crossing reviews. So I can pop into the notebook itself and we could walk through it. So I stumbled across this package recently called Shifterator from this person, Ryan Gallagher, on Twitter. And I thought, hey, that looks pretty cool. The first thing that I did was, I pip install the Shifterator package. So because it's a new package, it's not installed by default in the environment for notebooks. So I pip installed it and then imported a bunch of other packages. And then from Shifterator, the function that I'll end up using later is relative shift. So importing that from Shifterator. So I read in this CSV. You can see there's actually multiple files as part of this data set, but I knew that I just wanted to analyze the user reviews because that included, the text, the interesting text. One thing that I think really helps with kind of like work tutorial style notebooks is to actually show a little bit of the data. So another thing that I like to do is then actually like plot the data to get a again, another feel for the data. Like I mentioned, I wanted to split the reviews into negative and positive based on the grades. And I actually ended up using the median for this so that I knew I'd kind of get equal categories. If you've done any kind of text analysis, one of the more basic things that you want to do is remove stop words. And the reasons that you want to do that is just because they're so frequent and they don't really help distinguish, one text for another. Then the next two cells are actually ones that if you look at the viewer version of this notebook that I shared, you won't see them because I hid them from the output. So then finally, I actually run these functions. Yeah, like I say here, I thought it'd be interesting to like plot the data in what I called like a boring way. So not using Shifterator, what are some more kind of like basic or fundamental ways of looking at the data? We know that, yeah, these are common words found in negative reviews: game, island, one, play, switch, player. And then when we look at the same plot but for common reviews, which I've helpfully shaded as green, so they're positive. So the words are, yeah, game, island, one, new, etc. So it's kind of interesting that there's a lot of like overlap between common and negative. So that is kind of one of the problems that the Shifterator package tries to help us out with is, a means for us to compare these negative and positive reviews to each other. So those are two corpora based on frequency. The first graph that I plotted using the Shifterator package is an entropy shift graph, which only needs word frequencies to make comparisons. So this is the result. This is what you get. It's actually a lot more apparent looking at this that on the left-hand side are the negative reviews and on the right-hand side are the positive reviews. Here, like super prominent are things like one console per player and the kind of like limitation of multiple players on a single Switch console on a single island. Clearly a sticking point. And then the thing that I kind of noticed from the positive reviews is that there's a lot more like adjectives. If you remember just from looking at raw frequencies, they kind of looked really similar between positive and negative. But using the Shifterator graph, we see things like great, amazing, fun, relaxing, love, etc. that are, yeah, more positive sentiment adjectives. One other thing that I wanted to highlight about how I originally created this notebook is that I used the new quick save version to regularly save versions of my code as I had currently written it without needing to run it from top to bottom to generate a rendered output, which is the save and run all or commit option. So I would hit quick save, and then that would allow me to rapidly iterate. So you can see all the versions that I've created that are quick save versions. And then when I was ready to create the published version that I shared, I created a save and run all version to generate the rendered notebook that was run from top to bottom. Even if it's public, it kind of lets you like have a little bit of comfort to maybe make some mistakes and really get experimental without worrying about what people will see until you're ready. And then you just pin the new version that you want.